guys. First night on the train done. A bit uncomfortable. It's kind of the best kind of bit of fabric on a bit of wood. It's pretty much an extent of comfort. But yeah, managed to get a full night's sleep, so not too bad. Bunkmate's really nice, really chatty, so. And experienced traveller, so a lot more experience than me. He's been on four trips before this one. So yeah, he's stopping at Ulaanbaatar. There's only two of us in there, there's four beds, but yeah, only two of us. So but yeah, show you the toilet. This is pretty much what you get. You don't get any showers. You get a sink and a toilet, which I'll show you. See down there, going past, is the track. So yeah, it ducks straight out onto the track. And there's some questionable stick here. I don't really know what it gets used for at all. So yeah. So yeah, that's the extent of the luxuries of the Trans Siberian. Unless of course you go first class. Just stopped, first stop during the day. There's two stops during the night, but I slept straight through. So yeah, first stop, got myself some toilet paper and some water, because there's no toilet paper on the train. So yeah, that would have been fun. Yeah, not bad, had some breakfast in the restaurant car, and had an omelette, and I had an orange juice as well, and I asked if I wanted a small or a large orange juice, and I said large. It turned out I'd bought the whole carton, so that's a bonus. Ends up I can drink it throughout the way, so yeah. But yeah, head back in the train now. Only stops about 15 minutes, so don't have time to go too far. But there are some longer stops along the way, so might maybe go outside the station and see what's outside the station when I get there. Stop number two, absolutely hammering it down. So yeah, good time to take a shower, probably. Lots of doggies here though. Doggie! So yeah, just gonna wander around for a bit, see what's about. Come out for a walk around. There's not a lot here to be honest. There's a couple of stalls on the station. And yeah, it's quite funny because there's electrical outlets on the train in the corridors in second class, but they only power like shavers, so everyone's trying to plug their phones in and laptops and stuff, and it doesn't work. So quite funny, everyone's running up and down the carriages trying to get electricity, but they can't get it. So but in first class you have a socket in your carriage, so if you want electricity go for first class, but it's a lot. I think it's about £300 more for a ticket. So, but yeah, there is power in the restaurant car, but you just got to try and sweeten the woman up to use it in there. And also there's every carriage has its own attendant, and the attendant's cabin has power sockets as well. So again, if you try and sweeten them up, they'll probably be able to charge stuff for you, but hopefully I can make this camera last the whole way. I'll only be doing little bits and pieces. What I'll probably do is I'll probably put this whole journey in one video, because I won't be doing a lot. There's not a lot to do. I'm just sitting there reading, really. Thanks, Abby, for the books, by the way. So, yeah. Catch you guys in the next stop, probably. Next stop. Definitely getting colder as we head into Siberia. So yeah, we're gonna go find a shop so I can buy some water. Yeah, everyone in the carriages are really nice. Most of them are quite young. There's a family next to us. Lots of Swedish people, all wearing pink.
Hello, everybody.
they're all on a tour together. But yeah, other than that, there is a lot of Swedish people on the train. Pretty much everyone speaks English though, which is good. So it's quite easy to talk to people. Just been in a store and bought myself a bottle of vodka. As you know, while you're in Russia, you may as well. So yeah, I'm gonna go back, and quite a few people bought a lot of alcohol. So I think tonight's gonna get messy, but kind of the, everyone's so chill and so happy. Like, it's all travelers on the train. There's no local people or anything like that, so everyone's traveling. So everyone's got the same attitude. Just heading now down to the Swedish car next to ours, or a car full of Swedish people sitting out. They're having a party. So yeah, just heading out. Gonna join us. It's gonna be a laugh, I think. First stop for today. Well, I slept in past the earlier one, so yeah, that happened. So it was a good night last night. Drank all of our vodka, so we're gonna have to find some more. Taking a walk about. It's now 1 in the afternoon, so there's another stop at 5, I think. Also, I'm feeling a lot fresher this morning. Had a full wash, a sink wash in the toilet, top to toe, clean myself off, feeling a lot fresher, a lot better. It's just nice, but I'll be looking forward to a shower when I get to Beijing. So yeah, be good. We're in the middle of Siberia now, and it's frozen.
9 degrees.
And there's nowhere selling vodka, so I just have to drink Chinese beer. It's fine.
And it's not really good, but
no, it's okay.
It's nothing else.
It's cheap. So say anything. But yeah, probably drinking some more tonight. Same again.
It's going to be a traffic light party.
Traffic light party, apparently. Very badly organised one. But yeah, traffic light party anyway.
Never ever have
a
puked from drinking.
Oh yeah, okay.
This is my own bed.
Oh, perfect.
I've never
on a white couch of someone else. Yeah, that's perfect.
I've never ever graduated from college.
It's
everybody drinks.
Fuck you. You make all the smart people drink.
Yeah, everybody drinks, please.
Question, I guess. Okay, drink. Whatever you do, just drink.
Okay, now the lawyer is gonna speak. The only lawyer in this building. This is not a building, it's a train.
What is your specialization?
Taxation.
we don't pay tax.
And it's all only taxation.
Oh, really?
My team.
Of course it doesn't.
I don't never ever, but I think. So we promise we can continue till the morning, the sun comes up.
Sorry?
What? We will continue
until the sun goes up.
The sun goes up.
Roberto is there. Oh jeez.
Oh my
god. Okay, oh,
maybe.
I'm not promising, I'm trying. I'm trying.
Nazdravia!
I don't know.
Everybody drinks.
Yeah, thank you!
Drink!
Yeah!
Local time is 5 a.m.
I'm sorry, I'm on vacation.
Yeah. So you can't go to sleep if you
For me, it's Saturday.
Yeah.
Every day is Saturday.
Every day
is
Saturday.
Local time is 5:30, and that's why the sun is coming up.
Yeah.
And that's where my car comes in. That's pretty.
Yeah, it is.
Day 3, another great party last night. Finished at 4 Moscow time, so it was about 6 local time. Sun was coming up, which was awesome. But yeah, first stop I've been waiting for today. No, having a lot of fun. Definitely worth doing. Definitely worth doing. Recommend it to anyone.
Aww. Oh, shit. 6. Cheers!
Guys, I didn't see you yesterday. Completely skipped a day. My body clock was all over the place, and there wasn't that many stops during the day. So it was one early in the morning at Irkutsk, and then I didn't really see you earlier in the day. But I'm in here in Mongolia now, so absolutely freezing, so cold, but it's okay. This is where most of the train gets off on and off, so just said goodbye to everyone that I've made friends to, but I'm gonna stop in Beijing for a few more days to see them in Beijing, so that'll be really cool. Yeah, I had really good fun with them, so but yeah, right, so yesterday what happened, we saw the lake early in the morning, massive lake, so I think it's like 1.5 kilometers deep, so very deep. I think it's the deepest in the world. And what else? Oh yeah, we hit a cow, so we had to stop and check the train. Yeah, and then everyone just went to bed early because everyone had to get their body clocks back into where it's supposed to be, because the timing on the train is so, like, especially Russia, is so out. Because all the way through Russia you run Moscow time, even though the time difference goes up to 5 hours. So yeah, it's really confusing because you don't really know. You want to keep Moscow time so you know what time the train stops, but then your body clock's going to get thrown out because it's not actually real time. So like yesterday when I woke up, I didn't go to bed until 7 in the morning Moscow time because I stayed up all night, and then we looked at the lake and said goodbye to the people getting off of Irkutsk. Yeah, and then when I woke up it was midday Moscow time, which was actually 5 in the evening real time. So, and then like the sun went down an hour later, so that was completely weird. But yeah, I went to bed quite early last night to try and get my body clock back into sync. So yeah, I'm now running on proper time. It's about 7 in the morning. Yeah, gonna get another early night tonight, I think. Because I'll get to Beijing tomorrow, so about midday. So yeah, that's probably the next time I'll talk to you guys. Unless I get off later today, I don't know. That's okay, you continue. You bought it.
Yes. I can't decide which is worse. The mango one has the worst
texture. It feels like getting worse. It's so mouth.
Yeah.
It sounds like, something that should stay in.
Yeah, it's mango sick. I think the tomato. I really want to get the.
You can't give. I'm gonna get it out. It's like, here, have some.
No, I'm fine, thanks. No, I've tasted it. Sure? Yeah, I've got my beer, so.
It's so good.
No, I'm okay.
And it tastes
so. You actually get used to it.
Yeah.
No, I'm fine.
I'm really fine. I think you should try it. You've tried the banana, now try the mango. It's a whole different world, honestly. Honestly, it's a whole different world.
I can try the mango one.
That one is better than that one.
Really?
Yeah.
I think you should try the mango. Like,
oh, you can try the mango because it's worse.
Yeah. Or try them both.
Cheers.
Cheers, man.
One more?
No? Are you sure? It's good for you.
It's fruit.
Vitamins.
She likes it.
Vill ha något som bränner bra och gör mig skit för fort. Exeliten sa det god dag, hur gammal kan min herre? Vad har du något? Lägg dig till herre, kom hit igen när du fått skäl. Men detta var ju inte bra, jag ska bli full ikväll.
Do you think it's the same as if she was born so beautiful? She was so beautiful. Oh, she's too wet. Well, she's no fucking Zulu. She was a Zulu warrior. Sounds more tuneful.
Yeah, I think definitely. Yeah. Drink.
Sjung hopp la 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 lej, helan går. Sjung hopp la 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 lej. Och den som inte helan tar han heller inte halman får. Helan går.
That's much more tuneful.
Yeah, that's nice. I don't recognize that one.
Why was she born so beautiful? Why was she born at all? She's no fucking use to anyone. She's no fucking use at all. She was a Zulu warrior. She was a Zulu chief, 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 chief. And then you shout chief at them until they see away their drink.
Beds that don't move,
yes.
No clackety clackety clack, running showers.
Running showers?
Yeah.
And the bed is not rock hard.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Soft beds, maybe.
Soft beds.
Depends on where you. Yeah, yeah, yes. That's it. It goes into the sewage system, so it's going to be great. Yeah.
You get a good feeling.